to educators, and since you are all educators, let's just pretend you haven't heard some of this before.
Okay,
right.
Right.
So if you could just interrupt.
We're good at acting. We'll fake it till we make it.
Fake it, yeah.
Yeah.
Are you guys ready?
Stop.
Should turn off.
Sure. Break a lip.
Okay, good morning, ladies.
Good morning.
My name is Marcia Steinberg, and I'm here with a group of wonderful ladies. This is Susie and Angie, who are going to, we're going to present a short presentation for the educators. So thank you all for coming. We acknowledge your commitment to education and the fact that you want to learn more about this project increase your knowledge, and certainly, hopefully, our enthusiasm will spark you, our enthusiasm will spark your interest, and you will join us in our journey. We'd like to start with a very short video clip, so please relax and enjoy.
Copy and paste it into your browser.
I wrote the same, but different words.
Words have so much power over you that you still remember them, maybe from today, maybe from when you were small. Can any of you tell me something, a way in which words have affected you? Just today, my co-workers and I, while making this presentation, we were having a lot of trouble and at the end of it, they said, I want to acknowledge you for your perseverance in getting through to get all of this onto our screen. And if you know, that just made me feel so good because I'm really not a techie person. So that really impacted on me, you know, that perseverance really works. So that was a great positive one. Anyone has anything to share?
One of my father's friends once called me something special. And it's something I say a lot to children now.
Once when I was 17 and I was away at school, in a boarding school, a girl turned to me and said, "What, you can't spell, you're not even British." And I have to say that. And I have to say that on Wednesday when we were here, when I corrected Dara, it took me a lot to come out and say that I thought it was R-I-T-E-S and not, because somewhere it somewhere in the back there, I remember what she said. And it sort of puts this little stump on your confidence somewhere,
yes.
Even though I knew it wasn't actually, you know, true.
So the words really have a power. I acknowledge you and I thank you both for your courage to speak out. And I hand you over to Angie for your name.
Hi everyone, I'm just going to give a little background of what the Virtues Project is about. The Virtues Project was founded in 1991 by three concerned individuals who made a commitment to do something to counteract the race and violence in families and youth. You know, and Linda Popoff and her husband Dan and her brother John Cavlin, they did research, a lot of research in the world's diverse oral traditions and sacred texts and different cultures. And at the heart of all of this were the virtues. It is the essence of the human spirit and the content of our character. Here we have a list of the 52 virtues, which is the guide here, and these are universal virtues, and Linda's actually published them to help parents bring out the best in their children and in themselves. Since then, there are many books and research and resources have been published to educators, to governments, businesses to implement these virtues in our world. The Virtues Project is honored by the UN and endorsed by the Dalai Lama. And it's now used in over 100 countries, and we are hoping that it can be alive and well in our blessed Trinidad and Tobago.
So what exactly is the Virtues Project? The Virtues Project is a framework of 5 strategies that help us with character development. It's character education. Now, as educators, you probably are thinking, okay, let's see. What questions would you are you thinking of? Can you give me one or two questions that you might be thinking of now?
Where are we going to find the time?
Where are we going to find the time? That's an excellent question, thank you. Where are we going to find the time? The beauty of the Virtues Project is that it is not an add-on to your curriculum. It is integrated into your curriculum and into your discipline system. So you have not only got, you don't have to have extra papers, worksheets, books to mark, anything to prepare. It is done in context. The teaching is done in context. So you have no extra time in preparation and so on. You do have to do some work, of course. You have to speak the language of the virtues. You have to learn and familiarize yourself with some of these words here. And if you could just think maybe of what kind of school you would like to create. Can you think of using the virtues poster?
Mm-hmm.
Using the virtues poster, could you tell me, if you were choosing one word, one virtue, how would you like your school to look? So if you could take a look, would you like your school to be a school full of joyfulness?
I was going to say that, because I find in education children have lost the love of learning. I would like joyfulness in a school.
Okay, great. So that's your focus. So your focus is a joyful school.
Excellence and enthusiasm.
Excellence and enthusiasm.
Peacefulness.
Peacefulness. A school full of peacefulness.
Courtesy.
Courtesy. A school of courtesy. Anybody else? So you're all of these virtues here are things that you would want in your school. So you are going to create a culture without virtue. It would be the whole staff, the teachers, the admin, the students, everybody will be creating a culture of whatever virtues you want. So what we're hoping that you will join us in our journey, and we will learn a little bit more about the Virtues Project, how to implement it into your school. And it is not going to be papers to mark, it's not going to be a lot of extra work for you. It's a very simple system, but it does require, of course, learning a language, which, as we all know, does take some time. And you might be asking, well, what about results? What results would you have because of this? If just imagine that your teachers can spend more time in education, less time in classroom management and discipline, surely you're going to have more time to teach. And as Martin Luther King says, intelligence without character, intelligence with character is what true learning is about. So this is our goal. And we just leave you with a short song, which we hope will inspire you.
Mm-hmm.
Be highlighted, please.
That lights the fire of our imagination.